So we'll try to solve another problem of local attraction related to compass surveying. So these are the data that were observed during a compass surveying. These are the lines of a traverse and these are the observed bearings, fore bearing and back bearing. So we need to check that whether there is any local attraction present in any of these lines. And if there is any local attraction present, then we need to correct these bearings. So just like the earlier problem, we need to make this table. These are the lines, these are the observed bearings. We need to find out the error of each line. Then we need to apply the correction. Then we need to find out the corrected fore bearing and back bearing, and this is the remarks column. So just like the earlier problem, in this problem also, we will have to find out, at the very first step, we will have to find out the line or the lines which has a perfect difference of 180 degree between the fore bearing and back bearing. Okay, so by checking the difference between forebearing and backbearing of all the lines, we have found out that this line DE, only this line, has a perfect difference of 180 degree between the forebearing and backbearing. Okay, so if line DE has a perfect difference of 180 degree between the forebearing and backbearing, that means station D and station E are free from local attraction. This is the reading taken from station D and this is the reading taken from station E. When the difference between the fore bearing and back bearing is perfectly 180 degree, be it plus or be it minus, that doesn't matter, it has to be 180 degree. So when the difference between fore bearing and back bearing is perfectly 180 degree, that means we can say that station D and E are free from local attraction. So we'll write here station D and E are free from local attraction. That's what we'll write. Okay, so there is no error, there is no correction. We'll write the readings here. These are the corrected readings, no need to correct them separately. The given readings are corrected readings because there is no local attraction. Okay, and all the readings that have been taken from station D and E are correct, because station D and E are free from local attraction. That means if there is any reading here in the other lines which are taken from station D or E, that then those readings are also correct. But here if we see the other lines, there is no E, there is no E point, but there is a D point here in line CD. This is the reading taken from point D and this is the reading taken from point C. So when station D is free from local attraction, that means this reading is also correct. No need to apply any correction on this point. Point D is absolutely correct. So this reading of 209 degree 10 minutes is also absolutely correct. So we'll write here under this corrected back bearing, 209 degree 10 minutes. And this is the given fore bearing. This is incorrect, so we need to correct this. So as we all know, the difference between corrected back bearing and fore bearing has to be 180 degree. So we will reduce 180 degree from this to find this. So correct fore bearing of line, what is the line CD, no? Line CD is equal to, this is correct reading, 209 degree 10 minutes, 209 degree 10 minutes minus 180 degree. Now why minus? Because this is greater than 180 degree. If this would have been less than 180 degree, then we would have done plus 180 degree. But this is greater than 180 degree, that's why we are doing minus 180 degree. And this comes out to be 29 degree 10 minutes. So the corrected fore bearing is 29 degree 10 minutes. Now the given fore bearing is 29 degree 45 minutes and the corrected fore bearing is 29 degree 10 minutes. So we need to find out the error. Error at which point? This is the reading taken from point C. So error at point C is equal to, what is the given reading? 29 degree 45 minutes. What is the corrected? 29 degree 10 minutes. And this comes out to be 0 degree 35 minutes. This is the error. Plus 0 degree 35 minutes. So this is the error. Plus 0 degree 35 minutes. So correction will be minus 0 degree 35 minutes. Okay. So if we apply this correction at this point, we will get this. 29 degree 45 minutes minus 35 minutes, we will get 29.10. Now this is the correction applied at point C. We'll have to remember this, and we'll apply this correction at point C in this line also, because there is also point C. Now let us move to this line BC. This is the reading taken from point B. This is the reading taken from point C. Now we already found out the correction that needs to be applied at point C. So now let us apply this correction at point C and find out the correct back bearing. So the correct back bearing of line, what is this line? Line BC is equal to, what is the given reading at point C of line BC? 277 degree 5 minutes. 277 degree 5 minutes. And what is the correction that needs to be applied at point C? We have already found out in the previous line. It's minus 0 degree 35 minutes. So minus 0 degree 35 minutes. And this comes out to be 276 degree 30 minutes. That is the correct back bearing. So the correct back bearing, let me write here. We have found out 276 degree 30 minutes is the correct back bearing. Now what is the correct forward bearing? Because except these three readings, this is the line D, except these three readings, all the readings are wrong. So we have found out the corrected reading for the back bearing. Now we need to find out the corrected forward bearing. This. So we, as we already know, the difference between this and this has to be 180 degree. And since this is greater than 180 degree, again just like the earlier line, we will reduce 180 degree from this to find out the corrected forward bearing. So the correct forward bearing of line BC is equal to 276 degree 30 minutes minus 180 degree. Again, why this minus 180 degree? Because the difference between the forward bearing and back bearing is 180 degree. And why we are reducing 180 degree? Because this is greater than 180 degree. That's why reducing 180 degree. If this would have been smaller than 180 degree, then we would have been adding 180 degree. Okay. And this comes out to be 96 degrees and 30 minutes. This is the correct forward bearing of this line. 96 degree 30 minutes. Now what is the error? This is the given forward bearing and this is the corrected forward bearing. So we need to find out the error. The error at which point? At which point? This is the given forward bearing. This is the corrected forward bearing. At which point? This is the reading taken from point B. So at point B is equal to, given is 96 degree 55 minutes, corrected is 96 degree 30 minutes, is equal to 0 degree 25 minutes. This is plus, no? So the error is 0 degree 25 minutes, and the correction will be 0 degree minus 0 degree 25 minutes. At which point? At point B. So we will apply this correction at this line, because this line also has point B. Okay. Now this is the reading taken from point A and this is the reading taken from point B. So we already know what is the correction that needs to be applied at point B. So we will use this correction to correct this reading, because this reading is taken from point B and this is the back bearing. So the correct back bearing of line, what is this line? AB. AB is equal to, this is the given reading, 226 degree 10 minutes, 226 degree 10 minutes. And what is the correction at point B? -0 degree 25 minutes, -0 degree 25 minutes, and this comes out to be 225 degree 45 minutes. This is the correct back bearing. So let us write 225 degree 45 minutes. So now we need to find out the correct four bearing. So do we know what is the correction that needs to be applied at point A? No, we don't know. No problem. We all know, that difference between the corrected four bearing and back bearing is 180 degree. The difference between the corrected four bearing and back bearing is 180 degree, and since this is greater than 180 degree, we will reduce 180 degree from this one, just like these RDL lines, to find out this. So the correct four bearing of line AB is equal to 225 degree 45 minutes minus this 225 degree 45 minus -180 degree. Why this is -180 degree? Because this is greater than 180 degree. If this would have been smaller than 180 degree, we would have been adding this one. Okay, and this comes out to be 45 degree 45 minutes, which is exactly the given value of the question. So there is no correction needs to be applied at point A. 45 degree 45 minutes, this is the given value in the question also. So there is no correction, there is no error. Okay, but there is one correction that we have made on point B. So you can write this same thing here also, that we have applied the same correction of 0 degree minus 0 degree 25 minutes at point B, but at point A there is no correction. Okay, so this is your solution.